Hello everyone, let us take this topic, capital needed in farming. Before this, we have already discussed about how is land distributed in Palampur and second, who will provide the labor. This is the third topic what we are discussing today is the capital needed in farming. You have seen that modern farming required great deal of capital so that the farmer now need more money than before. And we also know that there are two categories of farmers, medium and large farmers and small farmers. It is so very easy for the medium and large farmers to arrange their capital because they have their own saving for farming. We will discuss from where they get the saving. You can able to understand easily. Then the small farmers, you know, they have to borrow the money to arrange for the capital. Now the question arises from where they borrow the money. They borrow the money from large farmers, from village moneylenders, from traders who supply various inputs for cultivation. And they also charge high rate of interest. And sometimes the small farmers, they cannot able to repay the loan and they are put in great distress because they are unable to give back them the allotted money with interest. So for them it is so very difficult to repay and they fall into debt trap. Now the another slide here it is given about how the factors of production are used. Now in our previous classes we have discussed about modern farming technique. We have also studied about land as a natural resource and as a fixed capital. All this we have already discussed with you. Let us try to fill up this blank and understand more about it. I encourage you all to be along with your pen or pencil so that here while reading I am telling you the answer so you can able to write it down now itself in your text on your textbook, or maybe if you want to write somewhere else you can keep the answers ready so that when you will get your own textbook you can able to write the answer. Let us start. We have read about the three factors of production, land, labor and capital, and how they are used in farming. Let us fill the blanks given below. Among the three factors of production, we found that the labor is the most abundant factor of production. There are many people who are willing to work as farm laborers in the village, whereas the opportunities of work are limited. They belong to either landless families or what will be the answer? Small farmers. They are paid low wages. In contrast to labor, land is scarce factor of production. Cultivated land area is fixed. Moreover, even the existing land is distributed unequally among the people engaged in farming. There are large number of small farmers who cultivate small plot of land and live in condition not much better than the landless farm laborers. To make the minimum use of the existing land, the farmers use chemical fertilizers and pesticides. Both these had led to the increase in production of crops. Modern farming method required great deal of multiple cropping technique. Small farmers usually needs to borrow money to arrange for the capital and are put to great distress to repay the loan. Therefore, capital too is the scarce factor of production, particularly for the small farmers. Though both the land and the capital are scarce, there is a basic difference between the two factors of production. Land is natural resource, whereas capital is man-made. It is possible to increase the capital whereas land is fixed. Therefore, it is very important that we take good care of land and other natural resources used in farming. I hope you got the answers. If not, you once again listen to it, you will get the answer. Okay, this is what we had learned about. Once again, I am going back. We have learned about the capital needed in farming, how medium and large farmer they manages their money and from where the small farmers they get the money. You know, in our textbook, it is even written about the story of Savita and Tejpal Singh, where Savita is a small farmer, where the Tejpal Singh is a large farmer, and Savita had to work in Tejpal's farm so to get more income, and because Tejpal Singh has landed some kind of loan, it was very difficult for Savita to repay it, and that's how they fall into the trap of this medium and the large farmers. The small farmers, they actually fall into under the debt trap of medium and large farmers. Read it, children, you can able to understand. Now coming back to the another part today, what we are going to do is sale of surplus farm products. See, after getting surplus, you know, products or surplus produce from the field, what they do, what the farmer does with their surplus farm products. Let us see. The farmer have produced wheat on their land using the three factors of production. You know that these are the, which are the three factors of production? Obviously, land, labor and capital. The wheat is harvested and production is complete. So the farmers, what they do is, this is actually about the medium and the large farmers, they retain the part of the wheat for family's consumption, and the surplus they actually sell it in the market. Okay. And mostly medium and large farmers, they supply the wheat to the market, and the traders at the market, they buy the wheat and sell it further to the shopkeepers in the cities. So they actually able to fetch good amount of their produce from their fields. I'm talking about medium and large farmers. But what about the small farmer like Savita? Now, small farmers like Savita, even one more name is given here in textbook, if you go through Gobind, they actually retain the whatever the produce, they get it in there from their small plot of land, and they consume within themselves. So that doesn't have enough amount or surplus farm produce to sell it in the market and to get more money out of it. See, there's an activity given in our textbook so that we can able to understand that you know, how the farmer, they use their money in the next year, and how do they multiply their income. You know, there are three farmers given, farmer one, and year given, year one, year two, and year three. And let us take this example or the story of these three farmers and try to find out how they obtain the money. And after that, few questions given that we are going to discuss. See, in case of farmer one, let us see. See, let us take this three farmer. Here it is written, each has grown wheat on his field, though the production is different. The consumption of the wheat by which farmer's family is the same in column 3. The whole of surplus wheat this year is used as capital for the next year's production. Also, suppose the production is twice, the capital used in production completes the table. They've asked us to completed the table. Now, let us do complete the table. This is the story of farmer 1. The first farmer. Okay. Now, if you see here with the story of the first farmer, how he managed his income, let us see. You know, this farmer actually, the production is done 100, consumption he has done 40. Surplus means production minus consumption. That means 100 minus 40 is 60, and the capital for the next year is 60. So again, 60 plus 60, 120 he has able to save. Now, out of that production 120, consumed 40. So let us see what will be the surplus production, as I mean surplus production minus consumption, how much it comes? It comes around 80. And the capital for the next year, how much he could able to generate? That is 80. So now again, if you see 80 plus 80, the production is now more in the third year, that is 160. And surplus, how much he has now? 160 minus 40, that is 120. And 120 is the surplus. So capital for the next year, how he able to get is 120. So what is the production here? See, he is able to increase his production. from 100 is increased to 160 and able to even increase his capital for the next year from 60 increased to 80 and from 80 increased to 120. Is it clear, children? Now, moving to the next farmer. Let us see his production and his story, what he did. Production 80, consumption 40. So, surplus is 40. And capital for the next year is also 40. 40 plus 40, again 80. And 80 minus 40, again 40. And here the capital for the next year is again 40. 40 plus 40, again 80. Now, consumption 40. Surplus 80 minus 40, again it is 40. And here capital for the next year is again 40. See, the profit is constant. What we see, the production is 80 only. And the capital for the next year, what is it? It's constant. So this farmer is not losing anything, not gaining anything. It's like constantly he is moving and he is not achieving anything for the next year from his farm product or production. So the capital also is not increased. Let us move to the third farmer. Let us see his story. Okay, production is 60, consumption is 40. So how much will come? Surplus is 60 minus 40 is coming 20. And capital for the next year, how much he can able to store is 20. Then again, he is, then 20 plus 20 is 40. Oh my God. See, this is what happened is it is reduced. Now the production is reduced. From 60, it has come down to 40, the production. 40 plus 40, surplus is nil. And then capital for the next year is also nil, zero. Now, for the next year, how much is the capital, how much is the production is? If you see, no production, nil only it will come. And here also, consumption is 40. So, surplus means how much he must be having? 40. And then capital for the next year also, because consumption he is doing, he is consumed. 40, the surplus is 40. And again, how much he must be, what is the capital for the next year is? Again, 40. 40 plus 40, again it's 0. So think about it, children. The production from 60 reduced to 40 and from 40 reduced to 0. That means this farmer is in loss. Based on this, the two question given, let us try to solve that also. Compare the production of wheat by the three farmers over the years. Let us try to compare. You know, the production of the wheat of the first farmer increased from 100 to 160, what we have seen. The production of the wheat of the second farmer was constant at 80. But the production of the wheat for the third farmer declined from 60 to 0. That is what we have seen from this particular, you know, the data given it to us to discuss. Okay. So the consumption of the wheat by each farmer, what we have seen, the farmer 1 was able to increase his production. Farmer 2 was constant in the production, and he just by the 3 years he could able to only produce 80, and then the farmer 3, his production is declined from 60 to 0. Second question is, what happened to farmer 3 in year 3? Can he continue production? What will he have to do to continue production? See, in the third year, the farmer did not produce any wheat and had to buy it from market. He cannot continue production any longer unless he arranges capital, as he has no surplus to invest in his production. So he has no surplus to invest the capital in for further production. So what we have seen is the third farmer did not produce any wheat. This is what the analysis we have done from this three example of the three farmers. And I think by now you have understood that how the production increases, and if the production is nil, the farmer doesn't left with any of the capital, and he has to arrange again his capital. And from where he able, where he will go to arrange again, he will go to all these big farmers or the big medium and the big farmers, and also to the village money lenders or the traders who supply various inputs for cultivation. This is all for today, children. I hope you understand these two topics well. The first one is that the capital needed for farming and sale of surplus products. Go through and try to read your textbook, understand it. Until then, thank you. We'll be meeting in our next slide, where we are going to discuss about non-farming activity in Palampur. Non-farm activities in Palampur. Till then.